This is the sump. So when you build an engine, you obviously always change the gaskets. And I've always found a very simple way, particularly with cork. It's different with composite and rubber gaskets because they have to go on dry. And because these cork gaskets tend to shrink and come out of shape, you don't want it coming out of shape because they'll leak. So an old Dodge, which I do, I put a very light smear of silicone sealer on it when it's all been cleaned. And to ensure the bolt holes keep the same size, put the bolts in reverse, which just keeps it level in the bolt holes. Takes a second to do, and save you all that aggravation of a leakage. And what happens is if it shrinks, it does that. Or come out of position. Just put the bolts in reverse into all the holes, keeps all the holes into shape, keeps the gasket in shape, just while it lightly bonds. Never ever ever use sealer on cork. You cannot compress a sealer. So if you have a lot of thick sealer on there, by the time you tighten this down, the gasket will spread. You don't want to do that and over tighten. It's just a very light smear on there of Vaseline is all that's required. Goes back even when I was a kid. Vaseline. That's what we used to build with engines with years ago. Always carry a drop of Vaseline with you. You never ever know when you're going to be lucky. You know, for chapped lips or things like that. The sump is just like, it's like a bucket. The oil lays in here. The pickup strainer, as I showed you before, sucks up the oil, throws it to the top of the engine, it runs and lubricates and cools and runs back down into the sump again. So it's like a reservoir. There's no specific torque for the sump, but if you over tighten it, the gasket will spread and crack. So hence the reason why people that do everything up with air tools tend to have more problems than people that rely on just feeling the force of a bolt. Golden rule is use your arm, just what God made Gavion for. Not to rely on air tools. That's all done now. Just leave that now for 15 minutes, let the gasket just settle and just nip it up a fraction more, then I can turn the engine over and then start building the top end, all the induction manifold, all the piping and whatever. So this is a one-off only type of its type in the world. There's no other car that'll be like it, no matter how hard you work. And if you ask me if we can ever duplicate it, no. No, never ever be duplicated. Like me, never find two of me, thank God. Whoever want two of me.